3, 2, 1, and we are live, everybody. Welcome, welcome to my humble abode. Well, this is a small chat. First of all, the seven nominations that Selena, the series, received on the Imagen Awards about two actresses, two Latina actresses in Hollywood that, as they say in Spanish, están dando la hora. I would love to welcome you. I have nothing but amazing things to say about our host today. She was one of my BFFs during the show, and to say that is, I enter on the second season. And this lovely alumni of UC Santa Barbara, a graduate of fine arts, plays no one but the one and only Suzette Quintanilla. And aside from being one of the producers of our show, she was the drummer from Los Dinos. But the one that played her in the show is Noemí González. And I would love to welcome Noemí into our show.
Hi, good, Natasha. How are you, baby?
Good. Love the flowers behind you. As beautiful.
Thank you. but yeah, I got a new. I went back for the new look, but for me, what I needed to do for the character, I was like, okay, but now it's my turn. So, decided to do that for this summer.
It's the summer stuff. Yeah, I got it.
A little highlight. Cute. A little lightness. A little light summer vibes. And I was gonna wear a hat too.
Yeah. Like everybody that knows me knows that I wear like thousands of hats. I have them in all. But this one is actually spotted at a little market yesterday. I went to pick up blueberries.
Oh, cute.
Well, congratulations.
Thank you. Congratulations, you too. The whole show. Seven nominations.
That is amazing. But also super congratulations for your Best Supporting Award. Girl, you deserve it. I know how hard you work. Not only so many lines and everything that we were standing through the show, but it's an amazing honor to play this lovely character. And
thank you.
I have like 1,000 questions that my fans wrote here for you. So
right.
The best one that I'm sure that everybody has asked you that. And has asked you that would be, what did it feel to play Suzette?
It felt like un honor. It felt like a huge, huge honor. It also felt like a lot of pressure that I put on myself. And it felt like fun. It felt like being a rockera. A badass. Like just, I don't know. I found myself playing Suzette. Yeah, I found myself in a lot of ways.
That actually brings, but I went to my neighbor today to buy a drum set.
Oh, nice! Congrats! How exciting!
Them. And I was like at a toy store, at a music store. I was like, oh my god, oh my god.
Yeah, the candy store, for sure. Oh, that's so exciting. Felicidades. It's gonna be fun.
So one of the questions, now that you're mentioning that you felt like a rockera, was, will we be able to hear you play sometime soon?
I'm planning on hopefully having more content where y'all can actually see me play, you know, because so much of it, I do have recordings of me practicing. But yeah, that was me playing and practicing as Suzette. So I look at it now and I like, you know, the new song by Olivia Rodrigo, that good for you. Like I'll be already like trying to like match the drums and everything. So I definitely know that's coming.
When I did the live with Carlos, we want to hang and like and jam. So when you're not in you know, new project filming, shooting, or vacation, yeah. Which I
we need to jam. That it would be a wonderful, wonderful time. Ya sabes, es una buena vibra, you know, just jamming with each other, like just, oh my god. And then Carlos and I jammed all the time. You know, as Dinos, we always like connected on stage. So it's just so cool giving each other energy so that we could keep playing like the Dinos. It's just really, really cool. So I'm there.
So let's see. The Edith Selena asked you, like,
what was your reaction to the nominations, but what? In Espanol?
Sí, claro que sí. So what was the reaction to the nomination? ¿Qué era la reacción? Ah, pues, mi mejor amiga me mandó mensaje que me nominaron y yo pues nomás estaba en shock. porque no sabía si era una broma, no sabía nada. I was just like, what nomination? Like, yo no sabía nada, y luego por fin miré mi email, and then I saw not only me, but all of us, and the seven, and I was just like, wow, oh my God. I just felt really humbled. Sí sentí todo el día como ya por fin podía sentir lo que hicimos. Porque no teníamos, no teníamos un premiere, no teníamos una fiesta por COVID, entonces para esta manera de esas nominaciones me hizo sentir más de lo que hicimos y para la raza y para representar. Entonces para mí era como, todo el día estaba muy emocionada. Sí, estaba muy emocionada. Yeah.
He went on like, did you hear? And I'm like, what? Seven nominations. I'm like, what? What? When? Where? I was so happy because
it
is, you know, it's important also to see, not only because we're seeing and hearing and feeling the love from everybody, and including my character that I find hard to digest, but it's been amazing. I
really wanted to thank you because I know you
worried about me, and I really, my heart, thank you,
because you were the first one on set who approached me and said,
hey. And I know that this is a hard character to play.
Yeah.
The best. And prepared us, you know, I was like, okay.
Yeah, no, we were preparing. We were all preparing. And I was just really thankful that they changed your face a little bit so that you can match her more, so that there was like a separation between you and her, because you're just so wonderful and lovely and sweet. Mm-hmm. And just all sisterhood. So to have that be, it shows your talent. Que puedes a cambiar así, you know, and play that person that shall not be named. For me, anyway, that's how I do it.
And the funny thing is that, you know, I ran into one of the producers from the show I did, like, or actually while I was auditioning, and worked with her in Curb Your Enthusiasm. And I did a little bit for that one, too. And she ran into me. I mean, I've lost 34 pounds, so it's even more drastic. But yeah. She saw me and she's like, is that you? And I'm like, yeah. And she's like, oh my God, I have to tell you, I did not recognize you on Selena. I'm like, oh my God, like I knew you as a comedian. I saw you at the ground. I knew that you were like all funny. And then I saw you in this serious role. I'm like, who's that? I can't believe it's her. So I'm like, oh, but. It's good to know. The first time I got recognized was at the premiere of In the Heights.
Mm.
So when someone is like, oh, I just saw you on Entertainment Tonight. And I'm like, what? You what? Oh, my God. So she recognized me, but because she saw my actual face.
Right. Put it together.
I would never guess. I'm like, oh, happy.
Yeah. I know, it's a huge compliment. You deserve it. You worked really hard. You did amazing. So I'm glad that you're getting the flowers, the love.
So did you. Like, we're so proud of, like, everybody. Everybody, like, made so... I mean, I know how hard everybody worked. I know how hard it was for everybody being in that super bubble during...
the pandemic. Oh, okay. Another question.
¿Cómo me sentí a cambiar mi look para hacer su set?
Correcto.
Sentió como, pues, de ser una chingona actriz que, pues, cuando cambiamos de look es parte de nuestro trabajo y no siempre nos miramos como una movie star, no siempre nos miramos como no sé, es parte del trabajo que me hizo sentir más como una actriz, que me voy a transformar completa. Y con el cambio del pelo, el corte, me lo dieron permanente. También cambiar el voz, el cuerpo. Sí, había unas maneras donde pues me encontré otra vez de nuevo, te digo. No nomás con la batería, pero también con la transformación, porque podía sentir cómo llegué al papel, cómo llegué al cuerpo, al físico, el pelo de su set, y cómo se sentía a estrenarme yo misma, a cómo lucir así, de esa manera, de ser tan diferente como yo. Entonces, me dio mucho como confianza en mí y mucho confianza en que gracias a su set, que de siempre era guapa, siempre estaba bien arreglada, siempre le importaba eso, y pues me hizo sentir más como yo me voy a cuidar siempre, si estoy vieja, joven, lo que sea. Dicen que pues Así, así es para transformarnos uno, ¿no? Para nos metemos completo y luego podemos ver cómo somos iguales de papel y cómo somos diferentes. Y pues me encontré mucho por la diferencia. Entonces era una experiencia.
Qué bueno, qué bueno. Well, I have to say that for me, it feels really weird because, I was like about 2 hours. Well, it was really 1 hour, but every time that they had to do my eyebrows, it became a 2 hour process.
Holy cow.
Between, changing, like eliminating my eyebrows, like me wrinkles, elongating, like ensanchando mi nariz, like they low down my eyes, so instead of being up, they would be like down. The little tricks like doing this the entire time, or learning to speak through my nostrils like this, or being on a Tai Chi squat to make sure that I. Oh yeah, and the baño, yeah, of course, like all the marks that they made on my face. And then after that, walking, I feel like me, and then all of a sudden I look at myself in the mirror, like, who's that? Oh my God. And then at the beginning that we had to go back home, and I had no eyebrows. So it's like waking up in the morning, like, oh yeah, I have to like draw my eyebrows to be human again.
Yeah.
Whoa.
How
So
long
that's
did it take you to feel that way, to get back to yourself?
Oh, well, immediately when we like on December 4th, I stayed another week in Baja, so I went to Tijuana and I went to the doctor, dentist, and stuff like that. And I went like nutritionist, like I'm like, okay, so I put this weight. I've been losing pounds without me wanting to do anything, but I really want to lose pounds. Like I want to shed my. They're like, okay, so they started me on keto, and then I started exercising again. So it felt good to start exercising and losing weight, and I don't know, feeling like me before, like
See, the working out was the big difference for me too. Sentí mi cuerpo más, I just felt me again.
yeah, because you and Ricardo, you guys kept it. You were like, nope, I have to keep it. It was like I was eating a lot, but I had to eat on keto because I was like all inflamed. I'm like, oh my God. Anyhow, so
From one of my lovely fan clubs.
Valentina asked you for proyectos futuros.
Ay, sí, proyectos futuros. Pues apenas terminé una peli que grabé con Eugenio Derbez y también está ahí Carmen Salinas. Samara Weaving también, she was featured in Hollywoodland on Netflix, our sister show. Y pues terminé esa peli, me imagino que va a salir 2022, me imagino. Y pues me da mucho gusto, es una peli de Lionsgate. Y pues yo soy la hermana de Eugenio y es cuando un valet se conoce con una estrella y luego tienen que tener la broma que son una pareja. So es muy chistoso, me da mucho gusto que tengo esa experiencia y pues trabajé con ellos y pues tengo esa conexión con Eugenio y Carmen Salinas y pues era una experiencia increíble después de Selena de poder ser eso. So me gustó muchísimo, espero que pues lo van y lo ven cuando ya se sale.
Well, I have an NDA, so I really can't say what I'm doing.
Really can't.
No, but well, I can talk about a couple of things. One, I have a project that I cannot say the name of it, but yay, it's an animation project. I'm starting in a new animation thing. Yay. I do have my album coming up. I'm a musician, I'm a singer as well. So I have a couple of duos that are really excited with people that it's kind of frustrating because there's a bunch of stuff that I'm excited about that I can't say. But there's one thing that I can say. In November, I'm gonna be part along Edward James Olmos, Luis Guzman, and the Dr. Cornel West, of something called Latino Thought Makers, which is we're gonna be. My phone decided to ring
Silencing.
right now.
Yeah.
So I'm really excited because it's a Rick Nájera. He used to be the CBS Diversity Showcase, head of the Diversity Showcase, and he put this together. And he also directed me in a play that I wrote for. It's a musical that I wrote that I wrote about an experience that happened to me. It's a coming of age story. It's a fish out of water story of my experiences as a quinceañera. I was turning 15 and I went to an Orthodox Jewish camp by mistake. So the So it is a play. I did it as in a form of a short play. So we're going to be talking about my play. I'm actually going to be performing like a 10-minute version of my play, and we're going to be talking about the new Hollywood. So but sharing the stage, you know, with James Olmos, Luis Guzman, and Colonel West. I'm like, oh my god, yes, I'm so excited.
Huge, yeah. I got to meet Luis Guzman recently, and he's just such a wonderful human. He's gonna be in the new Tim Burton Addams Family, and Edward James Olmos is of course iconic, but you know, legend. So like, I'm so excited for you.
I actually worked with Mr. Olmos. I've met him a couple of times. The first time I met him, I was the host of this morning show in Los Angeles. It's called Viva 107.1. So when 107.1, after Y107, that was an indie, and before it became La Superestrella, there was a time that became Viva 107, and it was the it was a pop and rock radio station, and I was hosting and producing the morning show. So I got to interview him, and he was so nice. You know, he was doing the Lali and like all that stuff. So I got to interview him. And then later I got to work with him for an insurance commercial. He's amazing. Come on.
I've only heard good things about him, you know, so I'm so excited for you. And now from like interviewing him to commercial to play, that's really, and your play, really, yes. Really exciting.
Yay! Yeah. So this is a question from me. How did it feel to transition? Because for me it was backwards. So I went from a comedy to a musical drama that is Selena. So how does it feel for you to go from a drama, musical drama, to a comedy?
Oh, that was fun. It was light. It was nice to go from the drama to comedy where you can. It was really light. It was sorry. No, pues sí, estaba muy bonito. Pues era muy pesado, pero todo con mucho orgullo y honor para ser parte de la serie. So to not be the drummer and actor and then just go and do comedy and make things light and funny all the time was just really nice change. It was a nice change of pace for sure. Yeah.
Right. Cuatro Diez dice son actrices muy talentosas. Qué bien. Pero también tiene que dice que fue lo que te impactó personalmente de interpretar a Suzette, y me dice lo mismo de Yolanda.
Yeah. Pues claro que sí. ¿Cómo me afectó personalmente?
Sí, ¿cómo te impactó?
¿Cómo te digo, mujer? Para mí, Selena y su familia eran parte de mi vida desde cuando era niña. Yo, antes de que se estrenó la movie de Selena, yo era fan de ella. No nomás ella, pero su familia, porque yo crecí testigo de Jehová y ellos también crecieron testigo de Jehová. Entonces tenía esa... pues eso, para saber eso con mi mami, estamos viendo a Selena y su familia más, porque sentimos como representados, sentimos como somos una familia latino, inmigrantes, muy humildes, y aquí tenemos una estrella, y pues está luciendo mucho ella, cuando era mi parte para hacer su set, pues era, me tocó mucho el corazón, mi alma, porque todo que ella y su familia me han dado, yo lo quería regresar por mi trabajo en mi papel. Entonces, para mí era muy emocional, era muy fuerte. Lo tenía aguardado conmigo siempre desde cuando terminamos. También cuando teníamos el break de 5 meses por la cuarentena, yo estaba con mi maestra, you know, leyendo los guiones. Nunca se fue el perfume de Selena en la serie de Suzette para mí, porque tenía que tener eso para regresar. Bueno, y era la primera vez que tenía esa experiencia. Entonces, era muy profundo toda la experiencia. También tenía la experiencia de la pandemia con ustedes. Nomás tú, yo, Natasha, 300 demás pueden decir que, ah, ¿dónde estabas cuando pegó la cuarentena, la pandemia? Podemos decir, pues, estamos trabajando hasta leer la serie en México, en Rosarito, y qué raro era trabajar en un trabajo y luego, pum, todo el mundo se cierre. Entonces, hay muchos niveles de cómo me afectó también personalmente, tener que ser esas escenas muy tristes. Y pues me metí mucho en mi papel y duré como unos 4 o 6 meses para regresar a yo misma, porque también teníamos que hacer toda la prensa y los holidays, y luego nosotros tenemos negocio de la industria de Pirate Season, so no sentí como yo por mucho tiempo, y pues estaba muy conectada con el papel y con la historia, y pues me afectó mucho y siempre va a estar conmigo esa experiencia de mi carrera. Va a estar muy, muy grande, no nomás por eso, pero por mi corazón y alma. Me afectó mucho.
Yeah, well, I would say you're here, but I would say the shadow side of that in the other end.
Yeah, ¿verdad?
Because, you know, everything that has a lot of light also has its shadow, and this time I played the shadow of that side. And one thing that I said, you know, we were for the most part in a bubble, and we were separate in different apartments, so in different condos, in different bubbles, right, where we didn't get to have contact with each other except for the set. And there were a few places where we could walk by ourselves at the beach with distance and stuff. Yeah. At the end of it, Noemi and I did like a little ritual, which actually I can, because it, there is something that I did learn when I was in Strasbourg as a school. One of the things that they taught us and not only at Strasbourg, but it was actually an alumni from Strasbourg that wrote a book, Acting from a Spiritual Point of View. And she was a Strasbourg also alumni. And she was saying that when you work from sense memory, the energy of the characters stay with you. Mm-hmm. And it's really hard to work those characters because they stay with me for months and months. I'm like, I don't want to have this character in my skin for months. So so you and I did this beautiful ritual at the yes, and so I kept doing a few of those rituals to make sure that, you know, como una limpia fuera, regardless of who I played, I learned that it is important, especially when a character is so intense, that I need to do the equivalent of a limpia to make sure that my energy is clear, to make sure that I don't have a little millimeter of the energy. The lessons that I learned from that character, you know, my whole family, I would say, is benefiting from, because I learned so much about trauma. I learned actually emotion code to release trapped emotions, to make sure that any traumas that we can have in life don't affect us in the present time, in our relationship, that if we have resentment, that if we have, you know, that sometimes we feel like victims, that like all this stuff, that we can move away from those and release that energy. So I'm practicing, and now it's like I see everyone's like, do you have a trapped emotion? So let's work on that. So I would say that even my family, even my sister's pet benefited from it. It's like, the dog has a trapped energy. Can you believe the dog was jealous of a spider?
The attention.
Well, you know what? It was because during the mega lockdown, the kids, and I didn't know this, I just like did this reading of energy. It turns out that he's like, he has an emotional conflict and resentment with a spider. And my sister is like, oh my God, how do you know this? The kids found a black spider and they put it in a jar, gave it an ecosystem, and adopted her. So they got to learn from the experience. And eventually they released her. But they released her because the jar fell in the floor. Well, according to my reading, it did not fall. The dog, it was pushed. So my sister was like, how do you know this? It's like, I don't know. I just like did my emotional code reading, and it said that the dog was resenting a spider.
Yeah.
So it is interesting, the crazy things I learned through this process. I would say that discipline, it was one of the big ones, because especially, you know, most of my friends that I know during lockdown were like looking at the ceiling, watching like Friends and Seinfeld from the beginning, watched so much TV. And I didn't get to do that because I really wanted to study this. For me, it was a very, very challenging character. And once I was in the show, my internet didn't work, so I couldn't watch TV. The little internet that I had, I left it for work, so I didn't get to watch much television. So I read a lot, so I got a bunch of books on my shoulders, thanks to the experience too. So
great. I learned a lot from that as well.
Yeah,
it was incredible. Yeah.
So it says here, ¿qué fue lo más complicado de interpretar a Suzette?
¿Qué fue lo más complicado? Pues, lo más complicado fue esta es una interpretación. Tenemos la verdadera Suzette, que es Suzette, que está en Texas ahorita. ¡Saludos, baby! ¡Te quiero! Ok, tenemos ella, tenemos la Suzette del guión, y luego tenemos la Suzette, que es yo con ella mixlada. Entonces era complicado de, pues, dar mucho honor, pero también quería que sería humano, que, pues, estaba dando algo real para todos ustedes, para que se sentía como, pues, eran, que ustedes viendo la serie, que eran parte de la familia, y pueden ver, you know, que nada era como, pues, perfecto, pues, porque la vida no es así. Otra vez mi alarma ya se fue. Entonces para mí eso fue lo muy complicado, es que para qué iba a ser, que era la balanza entre los dos, que era la de la verdadera, la que yo sé por toda la experiencia que he tenido yo viendo ellos, y luego la que tenía yo en los papeles, y lo que yo iba a hacer con todo. So eso, y pues la batería. La batería seguro que sí era muy muy complicado, porque regresé a música y sabía cómo llegar a un set de ser actriz, pero no sabía cómo llegar a set a ser actriz y músico, actriz y baterista. Entonces tenía que tener la disciplina, tenía que manejar todo bien para que tenía el propio tiempo para revisar mis líneas, pero también revisar la música. Y de vez en cuando a veces pensé, no lo voy a lograr, pero no sé por qué este día, este beat no me cae, no sé, no voy a llegar, me voy a dormir, y pues con Dios, a ver qué pasa. Y luego el siguiente día con la cámara, boom, ahí salió la beat, I'm like, I'm doing it. Aunque sí lo practiqué mucho, a veces tenemos que darle espacio y tiempo y descansar para que la mente pueda decir, así se hace, nena, y luego boom, pues por fin lo puedo hacer en cámara. Entonces era muy, muy complicado de tener esas cosas nuevas para trabajar en algo que me dio mucho, mucho, pues me importaba a mí mucho. Entonces era una experiencia, un challenge.
Wow, no quiero ni imaginar cómo se debe sentir tener que tocar un instrumento nuevo. But I'm really happy that you did, porque, I mean, music is one of the most amazing gifts the gift of acting can give you.
It really is a gift. I'm so very, very thankful, because it just me dio tanto vida a tocar la batería, you know, a practicar y también conectar con su música de una diferente manera, you know. Era increíble, y pues sí, también tocarlo, y puedes ver si lo toqué bien, you know, en este momento, porque se va a mover en la cámara, era mucho estrés para que sí se miraba bien todo. So, era mucho gusto de tener, pues, toda la bendición de que se trae con música de buena vibra, de buena onda.
You know, one of the things that I'm preparing is that I was jamming with a friend the other day. We started playing Si Una Vez. That, you know, that I haven't heard that song before. Until the show.
What?
Yes, and I had to, I you know, there was a point where my character she's kind of like dubbing the line.
Oh, yeah, she's singing it. Uh-huh.
like a super extra uber fan.
Yeah.
At the concert, and you guys were at the concert. You were shooting that, and I'm like, what? I have to dub her lines? He's like, no one told me this. They're just like, yeah, just yeah. like help them. I'm like, I don't know the song. What song are you gonna play?
Yeah.
So I spent the entire afternoon like, oh my god, the song on repeat, writing the lyrics. Like, he's like, oh my god. And then it's like, well, this song is amazing. How come I've never heard the song before? So anyhow, I was playing with some friends, and we started developing a grunge version of it. So
oh,
I'm
cool. That sounds so cool. Yeah, she's got a lot of attitude, so that's gonna sound really, really good with that genre. Uh-huh. I mean, look how you turn that around.
And I felt bad because I have a friend who's like a famous producer, and he's like, let's do a Selena cover, and I'm like, you know what? I mean, I would love, and this was like in January last year, and I was like, I'm not sure if I should be doing that, you know? Mm-hmm. I think it's like offensive that someone that plays character would do this. I don't know. But like at this point, I have felt really so much love of everybody's like, no, I understand the separation. You are you and she is her. Like, you are not the same person. And I'm really grateful for those that totally understand that. You know, I was just playing a character, and in my heart, what I really want is to tell the story of Selena and nothing else. So. A ver, o por lo menos la comparto en un live o algo así para ver qué piensa la gente.
Sí, así está.
A ver, ¿qué más dice? Oh, Vicky XMJ, Vic, ask you. Si pudieras conocer a Selena, ¿qué le preguntarías?
No le voy a preguntar nada, le voy a dar un abrazote y no lo voy a soltar. ¿Cómo no? No hay nada que preguntarle, nomás andar con estar con su espíritu y pues sí, pues nomás a reírnos las dos de algo.
You know what? I think that we know Selena, or at least the Selena artist that she wanted us to know, every day that we hear her songs, because her spirit is in her music, in her voice, like her laughter is still in her interviews. So mm-hmm. even though we don't know the person, like we know the artist that she wanted to reveal to us.
Yes.
And yes, we didn't get to meet her, but we meet her essence, and that's beautiful out there, you know? We're lucky that.
Yeah, we're very, very blessed. And I think that's part of what keeps everyone interested forever is que nadie va a saber todo. Nunca, no vamos a saber. Y así es la vida a veces, you know? Entonces hay que, pues, disfrutar de lo bueno y lo que tenemos. Y pues, como tú dices, tenemos su música, tenemos su sonrisa y su modo de ser en sus entrevistas. Y pues, así estamos. Y qué bendición que nosotros tenemos conectadas más a su historia y su leyenda de ser parte de esto. Y no todos tienen esa oportunidad tampoco, you know, de actrices. Qué bendición nosotros que tenemos esa oportunidad. Y pues we don't take it for granted, you know. So it's wonderful to take all the good. Mejor enfocarnos en lo bueno.
Claro. A ver, ¿cómo es tu amistad con Kristen Sarandos?
¿Cómo está? Pues casi no platicamos, ella tiene una niña, entonces cuando las personas tienen bebés, pues es diferente, you know. Me encantó mucho de principio, agarramos tacos, brindis de tequila y platicamos de nuestros sueños y pues eso nos ayudó muchísimo para que cuando estamos en cámara, porque pues qué bendición también, no nomás de ser estas mujeres fuertes, pero también que teníamos la oportunidad de mostrar a la amistad de ser hermanas, y todos sabemos las hermanas que son Selena y Suzette. Y pues me da mucho, mucho gusto que pues se siente eso en la cámara, en la pantalla.
Yeah, that's exactly what happened with me, you know, en el momento en el que ella y yo compartimos en el set, y en el momento en el que no estábamos allí, logramos platicar. Yo no tuve primera etapa que tuvieron ustedes, ¿no? De que, like, so, ustedes empezaron en noviembre, yo llegué en febrero.
Entonces, ajá, yo me... Pero ella también llegó tardita un poquito porque también estaba grabando. Entonces, es... lo que tenía era bien poco.
Okay, so to continue the question, and I love, I have to say that I'm in love with your fans. They are
I
so
love
beautiful.
Too.
Your fans are so beautiful. All the people that have been writing, that have been so not only so beautiful with you, but saying is like, no, you go, girl, like do it. Thank you so much for organizing. I love the design, and they've been sharing. I. You know, nothing but kudos to all your fans. y muchos a mis fans, a las dos jefas de mis fans. Thank you so much. It is so beautiful. I do have to say, to have people that have the initiative and to have the luxury of meeting them, thanks to, you know, social media, that have the initiative of putting together and collect things that you've done, that sometimes they're like, wow, where do you get picture? I haven't seen this in so long.
Yeah.
So, and they keep I mean, because of course people follow what you do, but having another voice of our activities, I got to be the head of fan club for Jesse's fan club, ladies and gentlemen. I do have to say that they're also very thing. So
they're amazing. They're so good.
Everybody from the show and the followers from the show, nothing but amazing things to say. Okay. So, ¿te gustó tu personaje? O sea.
Obvio. ¿La
tuya? Pues yo te digo que como personaje, o sea, no la persona en la vida real, pero as a character, it was so interesting to do from the point of view of an actress. Sí. Like to create such a complex character, because of course what I created was a fantasy. So did I like the journey that I had to go through? It was a tough one. It was hard, but in the end, I think that I was proud of like all the effort and all the avenues that I got to get what I wanted to do, which was to try to reproduce to the best of my ability part of like the sentiment in the videos. Mm-hmm. To honor the story of Selena, because it's not about that character, but it's about Selena's journey, and right, especially in the way that the story unfolds. She's just like a tiny little bit of that story. Los dinos, su familia, la carrera, los diseños, all that is the most important part of it. So to be part of the team made me feel very proud, and I'm proud of the work and the effort that we all put, because from the person that was cutting the wood to make the desk where we sat and the chairs where we sat, to the people that put the lights, to the people that had to do our makeup, to the whole team. It was a big effort. Everybody was like in the middle of like, you know, nerves, what's going to happen, this virus, are we going to make it on time? Like it was hard, but yeah. My home
has lo logramos.
¿Cuál fue la escena que más te gustó grabar? Nos dice la jefa de Natasha X Pérez.
Hey, pues tú, you go first, pues.
La escena, ¿sabes cuál fue la escena? Ya me acuerdo. Cuando estaban buscando al asistente.
Ah, ok.
Because so many characters entering the room, and then there was this lovely girl that I had met outside, and she was like so sparky, and she was like, yeah, I'm a badass, like, oh, Selena. And then the camera was there, and she went like, mommy. So then everybody, like, we all got up and started dancing, we started playing the music, and I mean, with so much festivity, there was like, so we started all dancing la carcacha.
No,
you know, and then she saw us like all celebrating, so she started dancing. So it was like when she started moving, everybody had to be like, okay, we all had to go to our go back. Hiro was like, okay, the director's like, I have to go back to direct, and Christian was like, oh, I have to be Selena. So we all, it was like such a joyous moment where we were all dancing, and then we were like, oh yeah, we have a show to do.
Oh,
so
yeah, oh, that,
what about you?
I think something of that was probably the first, el primer concierto del parte dos, como la flor. era la primera vez pues que se estrena la canción en un concierto y pueden ver que es un hit, es muy grande la canción. Y pues ese día era, me enchila la piel, era increíble porque pues todos estamos, you know, como la flor cantando y tocando para un teatro y luego Selena, Selena, y yo le miré a Julio y yo nomás le dije, se siente, está aquí, se siente que está aquí, como pienso que es donde se puede escuchar de todas partes. Me imagino que afuera de Tijuana, en las calles, pueden escuchar Selena atrás de las paredes de ese teatro. Y pues nomás me dio mucho gusto. Y luego había ese mismo paso, teníamos que cantar. Pues las cámaras eran en el público. Entonces nosotros estábamos acá atrás bailando y cantando. Y pues en vez de yo estar en la batería, Bri estaba en la batería, nuestro asistente de producción, Second AD. El Bonnie estaba en los teclados. Todos los que estaban trabajando del equipo eran los Dinos y nosotros de enfrente, todos éramos pues nosotros para dar mucha energía a todo el público. Y ahí estábamos los Dinos. Era muy, muy divertido. Y muy bonito.
So, a ver, ¿cuál es el mensaje que les quieres dar a las personas que te ven y que te siguen?
Uf, ¿qué es el mensaje que quiero? Tú primero. No me think about it.
Well, I think that the question that I get the most for people are like, I loved your acting. I love how you work. To transform yourself into a different thing. I'm an actor and I want to do the same. And my advice to those people would be act wherever and whenever you have the chance. And make sure that you love doing this because this is not an easy path. It's being an artist and being honest and depend on where you are. Some communities, some families, some cities, some countries are more giving than others, but it can be something very hard. Sometimes people don't respect the artists and think that they were just hippies, you know, right. They're like, get a real job, you know, like we're bomb. So make sure that you listen to that voice inside of you that tells you that you want to do this. Like a lot of people get into this business because they want to be famous, because they think this is very glamorous. I have the guitar player of my band used to say that Hollywood, a lot of times in Hollywood, you arrive in a limo and then have to come back on a bus. And that's totally true. It seems very glamorous, but a lot of times it's nothing but. I mean, it's not glamorous, right? So I remember actually a scene where a lot of the characters, like I was one of the main cast, but a lot of the characters had to stand in manure. And the producer were like, well, we don't have time. We're in a rush. So you're going to have to stand there. And, you know, according to the union, those are the kind of things that don't happen. But sometimes you're in a production where some people don't respect and value the actors. So, you know, we got to really love what we do. So the main thing is act as much as you can because you love it and discover how much you really love it. Mm-hmm. Then try to get as good as you can. So study because acting, I mean, we don't save lives in the way that, you know, that a doctor would do. We're not architects. We're not build a city. But we have a very important role in society, which is tell stories. So we're storytellers, somos cuentacuentos, and we're also the promoters of something called catharsis. We create through the way the stories are told, we are able to reproduce emotions and incite that thing that gets you to release the emotion and let go of the tension of the human existence. And mm-hmm. It's such an ethereal that subject that is hard to even explain to someone that doesn't understand this, how important this is, that when the arts are not lived and experienced, the society suffers. So yeah, make sure that you love it. That's my long lecture.
Yeah. Oh, it's good. Make sure that you love it. I mean, ¿qué mensaje quiero dar? Cambia cada día, you know? ¿Qué mensaje queremos dar? Y pues, talking about actors in conversations, I don't know. I mean, nomás quiero que se enfocan en lo bueno. Nomás quiero que se dan cuenta de cómo le están enseñando de cultura, you know, comerciales, televisión, series, pelis, para que nomás se dan cuenta que pues ustedes pueden apoyar a los temas que son latinos. Y pues, okay, that's just the message, que para mí que lo que es muy difícil es que somos un equipo muy grande de estar parte de latinidad, pero si no están de acuerdo de donde tú vienes, de este lugar en el mundo, pues no es justo, no está bien o no cae bien, pero tenemos que apoyar a cada uno. Tenemos que estar allí para que podamos tener más series, más pelis, más historias de contar. Y pues es muy difícil, que ya lo tenemos muy difícil. Somos personas latinos y luego encima de eso tenemos nuestra comunidad también que no nos apoyen totalmente. Es muy duro este trabajo, y pues es más duro que cuando vemos que le damos todo el amor, todo el alma a lo que hacemos nosotros y luego que se quejan. Es algo que, pues, perdón, pero es algo que es muy, muy triste, porque no vean que pues es un trabajo muy duro y que es más fácil de apoyar que ser criticón. Y es algo muy fácil que viene en nuestro sangre de ser criticones. Sí. Y si dicen, ay, muy, muy, se cree muy, muy, ay, mira, no se mira bien fea, o ay, mira, no tiene su maquillaje bien, ay, no tiene sus uñas, no tiene, lo que sea, de esas cosas no importa, debe de importar de apoyar a los latinos, apoyar a tu vecino y tu vecina para que pueden ver más, porque si no, pues Hollywood tampoco nos van a dar más. Y pues no quiero que nosotros mismos nos estamos arreglando para que fallamos, y eso no quiero yo. Quiero que pues todos seguimos adelante y adelante juntos. So, I guess eso es mi mensaje de eso.
Totalmente. I totally agree with you. Yeah. Bueno, tienes mucho Dreaming of You, te dice saludos, soy tu mayor fan, Noemí, te quiero. ¿Qué mensaje les dio el personaje que interpretó? Eso ya lo dijimos de otra manera. ¿Qué mensaje le das al personaje que te tocó? Ah, que por favor hablemos más en español, que no nos entienden en inglés.
Sí, me imagino.
Bueno, entonces esto lo dejo porque quiero quiero saber how are you with time. Si te sientes cómoda en poder invitar a de repente un par de chicos de tu fanaticada, chicas, chicos de tu fanaticada, a que nos hagan personalmente una pregunta que pues que no hayamos contestado ya.
Sí, claro que sí. Nomás tengo unos 5 minutos porque sí tengo una cita después y pues por todo lo que ha pasado, I'm like, uy, que casi tengo que irme.
I totally understand. Tenemos a Luca, a Sara y a Lunada. Entonces vamos a ir con el primero. Y por favor, sean breves para poder preguntarle a Noemí, que todos tengan oportunidad de preguntar, hacer una preguntita, ¿ok? And if in like in 5 they don't answer. Está Valentina. Vamos a ver quién se les estoy haciendo. Aceptando su request, que si quieren entrar, pues. Okay. Let me know if you see them.
I see them.
Okay.
Oh, my God.
Hola, mija, ¿cómo te llamas?
Me llamo Rocío, soy la dueña de Fans de Noemí González 88.
Hola, Rocío, mucho gusto. Ya por fin te conozco.
Ay, I love you, girl.
Oh, I love you too, baby. Gracias. Oh, babe. A ver, déjame ver. Espero que dejen. Porque otra vez. ¿Está Paz también, Natasha, contigo?
Sí, sale cargando.
Sale cargando.
¿Por qué? ¡Hey! Yo las escucho. ¿Me escuchan a mí?
Ya, por fin. Sí, ya te escucho.
Ok. Pero entonces, Rocío, hermosa, a ver, ¿quieres hacer tu pregunta o alguna pregunta, un par de preguntas que tengan tus amigos de tu club de fans?
Nomás veo la pantalla negra.
La perdimos, creo. Bueno, sí. Muchísimas gracias, Rocío. A ver, estaba dando la entrada a los del club de fans que se quieran conectar y se puedan conectar, pero I do have to say, I think I'm going to start going on Zoom and on Facebook or using one of those other platforms, because, maybe YouTube, because I think that the lives are not very, like, I'm next to a motor that is like super duper, so.
Yeah, it doesn't make sense. They need to get Instagram to level up.
Yes, level up. Bueno, mira, que hay una pregunta bien interesante de alguien que quiere ser actriz y quiere saber si es verdad que cuando se graba una película o una serie, todo es pagado por la producción, o sea, la comida, el apartamento y esas cosas. I do have to say that depends on the production, but in general, the part of the, by law, the breakfast and lunch should be provided by the production, and then dinner is provided, it's part of our salary. They give us, o sea, nos dan viáticos, y por qué te estoy hablando en inglés y preguntaste en español, perdón, nos dan desayuno, nos dan la comida, el almuerzo, pero la cena es parte de nuestro sueldo, por decirlo así. Pero hay producciones donde a veces no hay, hay producciones donde a veces te dan la cena y postre, y hay producciones donde te dan agua y siéntete que fue ganancia, pues. Todo es diferente. A ver, ¿qué otras preguntas? La verdad es que estuvieron buenísimas, se merecen esas nominaciones y muchas otras. Qué lástima, Natasha, que no llegaste a los semis, pero seguro te ganas un Oscar, tan linda.
Sí, a la segunda también. Siento que es para parte uno, siento que para parte dos te van a nominar.
Ay, amén.
Te lo mereces. Eso siento que por ti y por Jesse, que pues cambia, es en dos partes, you know, so.
Yeah, that is true, that is true. A ver, hay otras, mientras, si alguna de las que quieres se logra conectar, porque ya está esto. Okay, tu proyección a futuro, like, where do you see yourself in the next 5 years if things continue the way they are and things continue the way you want them to go? Bueno, me imagino que eso es lo que quieren decir, ¿no? Like, if things continue the way that you envision them and the way they are, where do you see yourself in 5 years? I think that's a good question. Thank you.
Very good question. ¿Quién la preguntó?
Eso es lo que estaba viendo aquí.
Yeah. Qué buena pregunta.
Zoe Sweets.
Zoe Sweets. Gracias, Zoe. Pues para mí, en 5 o 10 años, espero, si Dios quiere, estar viva, estar actuando, pero también de ser director. Me imagino que voy a andar dirigiendo mis mismas obras, mis mismas series, mis mismas pelis. Ya he tenido unas ideas, entonces yo ya sé que ahorita es parte de, pues, de actuación y seguir de ser una actriz fuerte y que, pues, puedo representar a ustedes y ser buena y que, pues, me dan la oportunidad de estar atrás de la cámara para que puedo tener más poder en lo que les puedo traer y lo que puedo representar. Entonces, si Dios quiere todo eso, y luego espero con una familia personalmente en el mismo tiempo. Lo quiero todo.
Como Selena. Mira, Daphne te pregunta que cuál fue la anécdota más divertida para ti con el elenco.
¿Qué fue la más qué?
What was the most, like, the most fun anecdote that you have in the on set?
Unos que no puedo contar.
I was researching about you, and so I stalked you a little bit, yeah. And I ended up with this anecdote that gave us
talking about Hunter, like how they were at the beach and he got all drunk. And they were like, oh no, we weren't planning to get all drunk and drink.
No, yeah. We had a good time. It was a really, really good time. I guess it was just, pues, estar juntos con todo el cast. Like, todas las fiestas, todos los momentos de celebrar con el cast, con el crew. Sí, era muy divertido de ser parte de eso. So I think that was the fun time. Cuando pudimos, porque no podíamos. Qué bueno que sí teníamos esos momentos de festear, porque cuando llegó COVID, pues no podíamos para nada. Entonces, eso sí fueron los más mejores. Pero para mí siempre lo más chistoso era el momento de estábamos en Big Bertha y Paul Rodriguez Jr. se echó un pedo. Y es parte de la escena, pero lo que no era parte de la escena era todo lo que estaba en improvisado, que era espontáneo, yeah. So, like,
everything he ate before that scene.
Era muy chistoso ese momento. So, es uno de mis favoritos del set.
That's funny. Parts are funny. It's like, it's so weird. That
it's
like
universal. Eso es, you know, yeah, todos se pueden reír de eso.
Yeah.
Espero que sí.
Maharade te pregunta si tú creciste hablando español o lo aprendiste, y a mí me preguntan si yo crecí hablando inglés o lo aprendí después. I'll let you start.
Okay, pues español era mi primer lenguaje, pero lo perdí, y luego yo con mi disciplina y por querer regresó cuando yo me fui para el colegio, porque me di cuenta que se me estaba, pues lo estaba perdiendo. Entonces yo le llamaba a mi mami y le dije, pues tú me contestas en inglés y yo te voy a contestar en español. Y también estaba estudiando francés, entonces no me dio buenas vibras que... ¿Quién es?
Hi.
Hi.
Oh, my God.
Hi.
Oh, my God.
Welcome.
¿Tienes una preguntita? Do you have a question?
No, solo te quiero decir que soy tu fan y te quiero mucho.
Ay, baby, te quiero abrazar. Ay, babe. Te quiero mucho igual, querida. Gracias por ser como eres y tener tanto amor. Y pues me da mucho gusto conocerte.
Solo te quiero decir que eres una persona muy bonita y muy linda, y que ojalá algún día te pueda conocer. Y pues tú también, Natasha, eres una persona excelente y muy linda.
Ay, muchísimas gracias. A ver, ¿tú qué quieres hacer en tu vida? ¿Tienes idea?
Pues yo quisiera ser, pues a lo mejor si se puede, diseñadora de modas o actriz.
Qué bien. Pues nada más quiero decir que aprendí una cosa nueva, que dicen que lo que admiras de alguien es porque tú también tienes eso. Entonces quiero mandarlo para atrás a ti, que tú también eres muy linda. Y pues claro que sí, porque tú puedes sentir lo que es linda de Natasha y de yo. Entonces quédate con eso para que yo también te regresa todo este amor a ti mismo. ¿Ok, mijita?
Muchas gracias.
Y te mando mucho éxito para ser diseñadora, porque eso sí se... Imagínate un día si pudiera tener un diseño yo o Natasha en un red carpet o algo así. Imagínate, sería muy, muy cool.
Claro,
gracias.
Yeah.
Muchos besos.
Besos, querida.
Bye. Ay, qué lindo.
Yeah.
That is so beautiful to see. One of the lovely things about being in this position when a show makes it, because, you know, we've been at this for some time, and then the show makes it, and you have the opportunity to meet people that always wanted to do this, and that they get very excited to talk to us, and we're just in our journeys of being right, and they want to hear from a person that is like, yes, you can do it. And you know what, if you're watching this and you didn't get to be here, we didn't get to read your question, I am so sorry. But I would say, you, what Noemí said, lo que dijo Noemí es cierto, somos espejos, todos los seres humanos somos espejos del otro. Sí. Y lo que amas en una persona, así como lo que tú odias en una persona, es tu espejo. Entonces, lo que estás viendo en otra persona es tu propia luz. Mm-hmm. Entonces, qué lindo si ves a Channing Tatum, and you're like, aparte de que, okay, he's hot.
Yo también soy hot porque yo puedo ver que está hot.
There you go. The hot in you. Es como dicen en sánscrito, ¿no? Namaste, may the light in me. The light in you.
Yeah. Pero,
o sea, yeah. Yo veo tu hotness because my hotness sees it.
Hotness. Let's be hot together.
Exacto. Y eso puede ser tan superficial o tan profundo como lo quieras. Entonces, mira, si alguien escribió ahí que quieren ser actores y que papás no los apoyan y que a qué edad pueden actuar. Mira, el chico de los Sopranos started acting at age 50.
Sí.
Okay. No, I'm sorry. He started acting at age 45. Was the thing. So he became known and he started working at age 50. Mm-hmm. So is whenever you're ready. So every rejection, starting with your parents, right? Every rejection is an experience for the acting world. We get rejected every second of the day. Mm-hmm. From people that don't like the way that we act to shows that we go to. So your parents probably are right in concern about like this is a tough journey. So how do you demonstrate that this is what you really love? Start doing projects as play with your friends. Like if you have access to a phone or to a camera, start shooting little projects. Do plays in school, do plays in your church, do plays in the community theater, start acting. And if they have the chance to see your light as an actress, they might not have another choice but saying, you know what, she is an actress. But even if they don't, once you're old enough to say, okay, I tried their way, I tried to be an accountant, I tried to be a lawyer, and that didn't work. But any knowledge that you get is going to be useful if this is what you want to do. Actores buenísimos. Abogados. Abogados son muy buenos actores.
Abogados, doctores, mamás, you know, los que construyen las casas, todos, you know, todos tienen el honor, es que, y se mira muy bonito todo esto de ser actriz o de ser rapper, rockero, pero es algo muy, muy difícil y muy unique, entonces tienen que saber que eso sí quieren hacer y pues a pensarlo muy bien y tener todo el orgullo y el honor de lo que se dedican.
Exacto. Entonces,
well, I can't get going, Natasha. I do, so I'm gonna have to take off.
I totally understand. Yeah. Thank you so much, my love. For
no. Thank you. I had so much fun, and that was so beautiful. These fans, my heart is full. Está lleno mi corazón y mi alma. Thank you. And it's so good to just connect with you.
Yes, and you know, please, when you come back, well, when I come back to LA, because right now I'm in Germany.
¿Qué hora son allá?
Oh my God, it's 11:25 p.m.
Ay, mira, that's so cool. Aquí son las 2:30 casi.
That's what I was telling you. I went to accompany a friend to buy a drum set in the afternoon. But of course, you're like, what? What do you mean afternoon? It was like morning. No,
because it was cutting off then. So I just heard that you got it today. I didn't hear that, like, when it was. So, like, that's...
Okay.
Across from the other side of the pond. That's amazing. Pues disfruta.
Claro que sí. Y bueno, para los que se quedaron con ganas de seguir conversando, these conversations are happening like almost every week. I'll keep informing you about them. We have, I believe, Jesse and Hunter coming soon. So I'm like, hey. Oh, I wish we could do like a Zoom. Once I learn how to do that Zoom that a lot of people can connect, I would love to do a Zoom where all of us.
That'd be really good.
In our year anniversary, I would love for us to do
like a round table.
Yes, a premiere or something, mm-hmm. Like to have our own little party.
Yeah, we deserve it.
And I send my love to your manager. I love how beautiful he is. Thank you for sending him my way.
Of course, claro que sí. Thank you for being so helpful, baby. Mm-hmm. Have a beautiful day. Enjoy Germany. What is it? I was going to say, oh my God. Guten Tag.
As they say, then, tschüss. Say goodbye. Bye, love. Bye, everybody. Thank you.
Bye, love. Gracias.